All of you, as we are studying chapter 16, light. In this chapter today, we will study about the structure of eye. Structure of eye means structure of human eye. We will study. This is the structure of the human eye. So we have to study what are the basic parts of the eyes. As you know that eyes is the very important part of human being, because without the eyes, this whole world is like black. Nothing is visible to us. We cannot understand the beautiful colors of the trees. We cannot see anything. So without eyes, the world is nothing to us. So we have to study the structure of the eye. So let's start with the cornea. Okay? Cornea is the front part of the eyes. This front part of the eyes is known as the cornea. It behind this cornea, what is there? Iris. Iris means this is the colored part of the eyes. Means this is the colored part of the eyes, and this is known as what? This is known as what? Iris. Iris. Okay. And inside this iris, small white colored point is that it is known as the pupil. Okay. So now what we have to do? We have to see the functional of this cornea. This colored part of the eyes is known as the iris. This colored part of the eyes is known as what? Iris. As you have seen, many of the people, they have black eyes, green eyes, blue eyes, brown eyes. This is due to the iris. When the light rays fall on this iris, what happened? This is the light rays. When it falls on the fall on this iris, it appears green, blue, black, brown, because the shades of the eyes depend upon the light of the object focusing on the pupil. Okay, now because here there is pupil, as you have seen that many times what happens, suddenly many of the light rays that suddenly started entering our eyes, and we are not able to bear that light rays which is falling on the eyes. Okay, so what happened if many more light rays this fall on this iris? So our eyes would have been damaged also. Though this is the pupil, which because of which our eyes is not getting damaged due to the more reflection of the light, because this pupil, it goes on increasing and decreasing, and it allows only that part of the light to enter our eyes, so which we can bear it. So with the one example, I can explain you that, like suppose do this activity at home. Stand in front of a mirror in a dark room. Go and stand in front of a mirror in a dark room and take a torch, okay, and put it in your eyes. Okay, take a torch, this is your eyes. Take, okay, now go and observe this, that when this light rays fall, torch light rays will be there na, and focus it on your eyes. What will happen? You will see that the pupil, it will go on decreasing. This pupil, suppose it is big. So as the light rays goes on to the pupil, you will see that it will go on decreasing. And this is because of the pupil, your eyes are not damaged, because this pupil adjusts the number of light that is falling on your eyes, so that it cannot be damaged. Go and see, take one of your brother and sister and go in a dark room and just see, place a mirror in front of you, or ask any of your friend or any of your brother sister to stand there and just look at their eyes, take in the dark room and stand, let him stand there and focus that torch in that light, and you will see that pupil, it will be goes on decreasing when you enter the torch light in the person's eye. So see this, and you will surely get the result, and because of this pupil, it is not be able to damage. Okay, now what is there? You are remaining with this outer layer where all the things are. It is like watery like structure. Okay, here you will see this, it is a watery like structure, and that is known as what? Aqueous humor. human. Okay, this is known as, this you will see, it is like water like structure, and that is known as what? Aqueous humus. Aqueous means water. It appears like water like structure, therefore it is named as aqueous humor. And similarly, the glassy like structure which is inside your eyes and the remaining portion is there, this is like, it appears like glass like structure. So this is known as vitreous humor. Okay, so now what happened, and this is a red colored part of the eyes, which is known as what? This is known as the retina. When light rays fall on your eyes, when light rays fall on the eyes, it get reflected back to the retina. Okay, when light rays which falls on your eye, it get reflected back to the retina, and through the retina these signals are converted into electrical signals, and through your nerves, okay, this when the light rays of any object fall on the eyes, through the iris it get reflected back to the retina, because many nerves are there, and this because when they are reflected, when they are inserted in this, they are reflected back on the retina. What happened? The light rays, it get reflected back, it get converted into the signals that is known as the electrical signal, and through the nerves, this electrical signal through the nerves, it goes to our brain, and that is known as what? Optic nerves. And that is known as what? Optic nerves. So this is the structure of the eyes, and you have seen it is thus the lens which allow the, here you can see this is the lens, so this allows the image to focus, and all this over structure is form of converging convex, it behaves like a converging convex mirror. Okay, so this is the structure of the eye. Here this is ciliary muscles which holds your eyes of the image. Suppose that many objects are there which are very near to you, and many of them are far to you. Okay, this ciliary muscles, this help us to visualize that image. When you will see, like let me explain you. Suppose some light rays fall on your eyes. Suppose this light rays is falling on your eyes. Okay, so when it reflect back to the retina, it appears in this way. Okay, means the distance here is more, because the object here is far away from you. Okay, so this ciliary muscles help in adjustment of this images which is forming on your retina. Similarly, when the object is far, this portion will get little bit bent, means it will contain less gap, and when the object is far, it will contain more gap in the retina. This is because of the ciliary muscles. So go and try this human eye. I will give you the notes, write down and study it well. This is a very important part, and it is very important question at almostly in every exam. When I have studied, I usually used to draw it very nicely, because I know that this human eye is very important, and the light chapter, it is very important question. So all of you study by heart. Thank you for today.